हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम हिमांशु वर्मा, वेलकम यू ऑल। सो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे यू आर नोटिसिंग दैट आई एम स्पीकिंग इन इंग्लिश। आई स्विच्ड टू इंग्लिश बिकॉज सम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स वर गेटिंग प्रॉब्लम इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग द हिंदी लैंग्वेज। हाउएवर, आई एम नॉट दैट मच फ्लुएंट इन इंग्लिश, बट स्टिल आई विल ट्राई माई बेस्ट टू एक्सप्लेन ईच एंड एवरी टॉपिक क्लियरली। सो फ्रेंड्स, नाउ विदाउट वेस्टिंग मोर टाइम वी स्टार्ट आवर कोर्स। एज यू नो, अप टू नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड डिफरेंट मेटल्स, अलॉयज, resistivity of alloys, hardness and other properties of alloy. In today lecture, we will study about corrosion. In simple language, we can say decaying of material with time is known as corrosion. In case of metals and ceramics, it is known as corrosion, but in case of polymers, it is known as degradation. Now, corrosion is the result of electrochemical reaction. Electrochemical reaction is that reaction which contains oxidation as well as reduction. The element whose oxidation takes place is known as anodic element, and that site is known as anodic site. Similarly, the element whose reduction takes place is known as cathodic element, and that site is known as cathodic site. In oxidation, there is a loss of electron from the element, and in case of reduction, there is a gain of electron to the element. In the following example, M is any metal whose oxidation takes place and it releases N electrons, and consequently metallic ion Mn positive forms. This reaction is an example of oxidation reaction. The occurrence of oxidation reaction is very easy. It only requires a metal and presence of oxygen. The only oxidation does not cause corrosion. To complete the electrochemical reaction, reduction should also be happened so that the electrons which are released in oxidation process can be used. Now, if we have free electrons, then there are number of situations for which reduction can take place. Number one, suppose there is an acidic medium. Now, in acidic medium, H positive ions will be present, and those H positive ions will combine with free electrons which were generated by oxidation reaction, and result will form hydrogen gas. This is the one way of reduction. Number two, suppose there is an acidic medium in which oxygen is also present. In that case, oxygen gas plus 4 H positive ions and 4 electrons will combine to form 2 molecules of water. This is also an example of reduction. Number 3 is, suppose there is a presence of oxygen and water only, means no acidic medium is there. In this case also, oxygen and water will use the 4 electrons and reduce to 4 hydroxyl ion. So here we discussed 3 ways of reduction. In the environment, we always have oxygen and water molecules in the form of humidity. So in open environment, any metal, for example iron, will get oxidized very easily due to presence of oxygen. Now the released electrons in oxidation process can be used in this reduction reaction where only oxygen and water molecules are required. Therefore, the combination of these two reactions will result a electrochemical reaction. And if we add these two reactions, then FeOS3 compound will form, and which is a type of rust only. Here we should remember one thing: anodic site means where oxidation is happening, and cathodic site means where reduction is happening should be different. If anodic site and cathodic site are same, then corrosion will not occur. The reason is very simple. If an element get oxidized and the same element get reduced also, then the net reaction is zero. Therefore, the oxidation and reduction should happen at different sites for the occurrence of corrosion. We should remember one thing also: only oxidation can't result corrosion, and similarly, only reduction can't result corrosion. For corrosion, oxidation and reduction should take place with same rate but at different sites. Here we see some elements which are arranged in a special order. The elements which are placed in the top of the series are highly prone to oxidation, and as we move downward in this series, the tendency of oxidation reduces. Similarly, the lower elements are highly prone to reduction, and as we move upward in this series, the tendency of reduction get reduced. It means the elements which have high tendency of oxidation will have low tendency of reduction, and vice versa. This series is known as galvanic series. I have written down only some of the elements. The complete galvanic series is shown in the picture. Now suppose we pick two elements which are having large gap in this series. For example, one element is zinc and another one is copper. If we placed zinc and copper metal side by side, then this couple has a very high tendency for corrosion because zinc will get easily oxidized and the free electrons released by zinc will be absorbed by copper and copper get reduced. Here, zinc will act as an anodic site and copper will act as an cathodic site. And due to high tendency of electrochemical reaction for this couple, which is actually known as galvanic couple, and this type of corrosion is known as galvanic corrosion. Here we have to take care one thing. If we want to reduce corrosion, then metals combination should be selected such that they are nearby in galvanic series. Now after learning the corrosion, we define one term known as corrosion penetration rate, represented by CPR. And CPR is equal to Kw divided by rho At. Here K is a constant and W is the loss of metal in a given time t. Rho is the density of metal, A is the area of metal which is exposed to corrosion, and T is the given time. For a given metal, rho and A are also constant, therefore corrosion penetration rate will solely depends upon W upon T, and W upon T is the loss of mass due to corrosion per unit time. If loss of mass in a unit time is more, then corrosion penetration rate will be more. We should also remember the metals which are undergone cold working are more prone to corrosion instead of those metals which are annealed or hot worked. Now we see some of the methods for the prevention of corrosion. First method for the prevention of corrosion is passivation or inhibitor. In this method, we create environmental conditions such that a protective layer automatically forms around the metal. For example, in case of copper, a copper oxide layer is formed which act as a protective layer and prevent the further corrosion. In case of aluminium also, a aluminium oxide layer Al2O3 is formed around the metal which also acts as protective layer. Now second method of corrosion prevention is cathodic protection. Suppose a metal get oxidized and form metal cation and release N electrons. This is correspond to oxidation reaction. Now the electrons lost by this metal ion are provided back by some other metal. So in first cycle, this metal is getting oxidized and in next cycle, this metal is get reduced. Therefore, in this case, the same metal is getting oxidized and then reduced. So there is no net electrochemical reaction. Hence, corrosion will not occur. We can also say, in this case, anodic site and cathodic sites are same. In the following example, we see if a steel metal is buried in the land, then it will get oxidized. But if we connect the steel with a metal which exists in the top portion of galvanic series, for example magnesium, then magnesium have large tendency for oxidation than steel. So in front of magnesium, steel will act as a reducing element and therefore steel will oxidize as well as reduced. So there is no corrosion on steel. Now third method for corrosion prevention is anodic protection. Anodic protection is also known as sacrificial anode. Here we can save a metal from corrosion if we put a layer of that metal which exists in the top of galvanic series. For example, coating of zinc on the steel. Here zinc has tendency to easily oxidize, so corrosion of only zinc will happen. This method for the prevention of corrosion is due to sacrifice of zinc layer. The coating of zinc on the steel can be done by electroplating, and this process where we coat the zinc on the steel or any other metal is known as galvanization. So friends, we stop here and in next video we will start mechanical properties of metal. See you in next video. Goodbye and thanks for watching.